When video games were first created, every single developer wanted to create their own idea, be the next best thing, and really care about their reputation in the game industry. However, as time went on, people realized, why create your own idea when you could just rip off another popular game series and call it your own? Welcome back to Top 5 Gaming, where today we're counting down 5 video game ripoffs that made millions. But real quick, punch the like button if you've ever played any of these games, and quick question for all you super special commenters. How do you feel about ripoffs? Would you play them or no? Let us know, and one lucky person gets pinned at the top for everyone to see. Anyways, let's get right into it. Number 5. Angry Birds. When Angry Birds first released back in 2009, it was an instant global sensation. People were just obsessed with flinging the Angry Birds at castles filled with pigs, and since then the franchise has sort of spiraled out of control a bit. There are like a ton of spin-off games, an unbelievable amount of merchandise, a pretty successful sequel, and even a Hollywood movie. Obviously, you would expect such an awesome game series to have been pretty original, but in truth, Angry Birds is nothing but a ripoff. Crush the Castle was released around 6 months before the first Angry Birds game, and features gameplay that is basically exactly the same. The only real difference is that instead of firing birds out of a slingshot into buildings filled with pigs, you're firing rocks and bombs at medieval knights and kings who are trying to hide away in castles. Unlike Angry Birds, which was on the iPhone, this game was first released on the popular flash game site Armor Games. It's a pretty simple game and seems perfect for mobile gaming, so it's not surprising that a more colorful and kid-friendly version of the game found itself becoming one of the most popular apps on the App Store. So the real question is, how much is this ripoff turned mega franchise actually worth? Well, back in 2012, the company behind the popular Facebook game Farmville tried to buy the rights to the game for a crazy $2.5 billion. And considering how far the game has come in the last 6 years since then, it's probably worth way more than that. Number 4. Guitar Hero. Guitar Hero is another one of those classic games that have shaped generations of gamers. I'm sure pretty much anyone has gone to like a bowling alley or an arcade and seen a Guitar Hero booth in the corner, and has probably played it too. There's just something pretty awesome about holding a Guitar Hero guitar in your hand and rocking out as if you were an actual rock star. But it might surprise you to find out that Guitar Hero wasn't an original concept, and most of its gameplay was ripped off from an earlier game called Guitar Freaks. This rhythm game was released way back in 1999, a full 6 years before Harmonix released the first Guitar Hero game for PlayStation 2. If you look at the gameplay of Guitar Hero and then compare it to the older Guitar Freaks, you'll see some pretty clear comparisons. Now, of course, Guitar Hero has the graphical edge, but it uses basically the same system of bars heading toward a line as the main gameplay mechanic. Not only that, Guitar Freaks even had a guitar ship controller that you strum and push buttons on in the exact same way as a Guitar Hero controller. Even crazier, the series is technically still running, but instead of being called Guitar Freaks, it's now being called Ghidorah. The games are so similar, in fact, that in 2008, Konami actually sued the developer of Guitar Hero for violating 3 patents it had on drum and guitar-based music games. Now, that lawsuit was settled, and the claims dismissed, meaning Harmonix probably paid Konami off. And considering that Guitar Hero is worth around $2 billion at the time, that likely wasn't hard for them to do. Number 3. Fortress Craft. Minecraft is probably one of the biggest games to have come out in the last 10 years, and has made its creator Notch and Microsoft, who bought the rights from him, a lot of money. Over the years, a lot of different game developers have tried to jump on the Minecraft bandwagon, with voxel-style games becoming more and more popular over time. One of the most popular games that took inspiration from Minecraft was an Xbox Live indie game released in 2011 called Fortress Craft. This game was pretty similar to Minecraft, with players crafting and mining their way through the world. One way it was incredibly different from its inspiration was through the use of Xbox Live avatars, because the game literally used your Xbox avatar as your in-game avatar. But it wasn't this little quirk that made the game so popular, it was the fact that the YouTuber Keemstar was involved with the PR for the game. These days you probably know Keemstar as the host of the popular YouTube news channel Drama Alert, but he also had a hand in the development, funding, and promotion of a whole bunch of small indie games. We don't know exactly how much Fortress Craft has made over the years, but a tweet from Keemstar himself in 2015 says that he makes so much money from the video games he's involved with that he doesn't actually need to work at all, and the only reason he still makes Drama Alert videos is because he's passionate about the content. So basically, Fortress Craft probably made quite a bit of money, giving it a definite spot on this list. Number 2. Video game ripoffs aren't exactly a new thing. This is the Pop Station, a Chinese electronic handheld game that was designed specifically to rip off the PlayStation Portable and try to write off some of its success. The original Pop Station had 4 available games: a soccer game, a Street Fighter ripoff, a submarine invasion game, and a game called Fortress Guardian. Now, I know what you're thinking. A PSP ripoff that includes 4 games can't be too bad, right? Well, you are really wrong. The Pop Station isn't a games console like you think it is. It doesn't play video games like the PSP did at all. Instead, the Pop Station played video games that are basically little colored figures moving about on the screen. I mean, these video games looked like they could have came straight out of the 80s or something. The Chinese company who made the original Pop Station didn't stop there either. Since their PSP ripoff, the Pop Station company has ripped off even more consoles and designs, from the Nintendo DS to a laptop and even a PlayStation 3 and BlackBerry phone. All of the games on these systems are pretty similar, all using the same sort of like pixely display, terrible music, and awful controls. Surprisingly though, these crap consoles have made quite a lot of money over the years, and although they really are terrible, they have become a bit of fan favorite in the retro gaming community. I mean, there's a British YouTuber called Ashens that basically built his entire YouTube career by showing off these terrible games, which just goes to show how popular they actually are. Number 1. Nova. When smartphones started becoming more readily available to the general public, more and more companies began to make video games for them. One such game is Near Orbit Vanguard Alliance, or NOVA for short. This mobile game, first released in December of 2009, is a pretty shameless mobile ripoff of the Halo franchise, and it's actually pretty good. The game takes place in the far future, where Earth is no longer able to sustain life. Instead, humanity lives on huge satellites called Near Orbitals, which were protected by the Near Orbit Vanguard Alliance. The whole game is basically about protecting these satellites from the hordes of alien Xenos, which look strangely like the enemies from the Halo franchise. This game even has an online multiplayer mode, which allows people to connect either over local Wi-Fi, local Bluetooth, or online through Gameloft Live. The most recent version of the game is called Nova Legacy, and was released in 2017. This is basically like an HD remaster of the first game in the series, and since its release, it already has over 1 million downloads, meaning it's a pretty popular game. Once again, considering it's a mobile game, it's pretty obvious that it has microtransactions, and with that number of downloads, you could guess that it has made a lot of cash. And there's our video on the top 5 video game ripoffs that made millions. If you enjoyed the video, like I said, make sure to hit that subscribe button and leave a like. I mean, we got to hook up with Epic Games, so every time you like this video, you get 1,000 free V-Bucks. 100% legit, totally not just a bait for likes, but yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.